Delight and jubilation best describe the public reaction in Aylesbury immediately after the county councillor's no development decision. 200 local residents took time off to listen to the planning debate and the announcement of the decision.
Absolutely fantastic. It's a great day for democracy.
We live on an area where we have a massive amount of traffic already. We can't cope with what we've got, and if they send 190 lorries a day through the village,
365 days a year,
it'll be absolutely
for 18 years.
When you heard that news, how did you feel?
I could have cried with joy, because we formed a small committee just over a year ago to fight this. And we've had the most marvellous support from everybody in Burnham, Taplow and the surrounding areas. And it's only through all their tremendous help that we've managed to get it to this stage.
Summerlee's Gravel had applied to dig out 1.5 million tonnes of sand from 120 farmland acres next to Burnham beaches. The request disturbed thousands of people who use the ancient 380-acre woodlands looked after by the City of London.
Well, we are very glad that it's happened. And I'm quite sure that the local people, the local parish council, and mainly our committee, are very grateful to the members of Buckinghamshire County Council for their action.
Today, councillors heard speaker after speaker express concern about the effects on the water table caused by the digging and worries about dust and pollution from 190 lorries a day.
Access and transport was also a concern. There was also a lot of views expressed about the general upheaval in a rural residential area and a feeling that this was really too much. It's a big site, you see. It's something like 100 acres.
The gravel companies say they'll appeal because the councillors had ignored advisers who said the giant excavation should go ahead. But those councillors and lovers of Burnham beaches have strong allies. The Queen Mother has twice written to the County Council, and the City of London has been a strong supporter of those who want the area around Burnham beaches staying green. Simon Neave, Thames News.